We're the Music of Eric Consort, and what we like to do is play music on instruments that are strange to most people, so old that they're new. We, on most of our programs, play the music of the time of the instruments back in the early days. As a matter of fact, we have music here that is from the early 16th century and 17th and 18th. And we also like to mix in some more familiar stuff so that you can hear these unusual instruments in music that is a little less like what you just heard. The instruments that we have are historical reproductions of the actual instruments that were used in the Renaissance and early Baroque, and our time span that we're going to play them on today goes from the Spanish Cavalier, which is close to the end, to interesting 1944 theme from 20th Century Fox that we'll tell you about. It's a very lovely tune. The first tune that we played was called Passamento Pubblico Dance. It's a Passamento dance, and it's from a collection called Terpsichore. Terpsichore was the goddess of the dance, and this collection has 312 dances in it. So we can spend, you know, all night playing that book. The dance was very, very important in the early days. It was one of the chief forms of amusement at all levels of society, from the royalty down to the peasants. And there is published music for all three levels. The one that we started with was from Terpsichore, and Terpsichore was generally the music of the French court. So this is sort of ritzy music back then. The next piece that we're going to play is English. It's by Thomas Morley, who wrote Elizabethan songs, and it's called Now Is the Month of May, pretty good tune for today. It was published in 1595, so it's a little newer than the earliest that we're going to play, and it is a form that's called a madrigal, which was very, very popular and became sort of the big English thing of the time. So now is the month of May, Thomas Morley published in 1595.
Thank you.
one by Andrew Susato. It's called the Dazzeria. They're all dances, probably simpler dances for the lower folks. This one, Wonder Night Falling, is a simple dance in the round, and it means my friend. It will feature Nina on her brand new instrument, which is a part of Sue's viola. It's like a little viola da gamba, but different.
Thank you.
early music times, are going to play two Native American melodies, which I have not very authentically harmonized. The music of the Native American flute is just a single line, but we have three flutes, and I wanted to have three flutes playing together. There are two tunes, one from an Omaha tribe, one from an Alabama. The two tunes, Peace and Fellowship, we'll start with that, and then we'll go directly into the duck dance. So wait a little second before you acknowledge it, if you think it's worth acknowledging. Native American flutes. This is about the same as a tenor recorder. It's basically in C, and it works like a recorder in that there's a wind wave and a bevel that you blow across that initiates vibration. It looks different, it sounds different. Early music. This is a tune, it's a brawl, and a brawl is sort of like leaping dances, as we, the word brawl comes from the same source. So this is a dance that's probably pretty athletic, pretty springy, pretty low middle class. And it's called Roll de Burgundian, which means the dance of the Burgundian, very popular, very big group of people in France who lived in Burgundy, and they made good wine too. This is from a collection called the Liber Primus Labiorum Carminum, which means something like this, the first book of the tunes. The composer is Claude Gervais, who lived from 1521 to 1560. So this is the Grand Bourgogne.
Thank you. Thank you.
it's not the same notes at all. It's got the same idea, the same motion, the same words. And it was the lead track on an album that he put out in 1965, I think, or 66. And after it was included in a movie, you can remember the movie? The Graduate. It was included in the movie The Graduate. It became very, very popular. And it was set by Simon Garfunkel, and it was the composer tied up with the original English folk singer, who was a little bit miffed because of the money he was making on her song, but he had acknowledged her. So this now is the tune that was in The Graduate, and it's the same concept and the same words, Scarborough Fair.
Thank you.
Irish and folklore and folk song. These are two songs. The first one's in Sherwood Lives South Robin Hood, and the second one is Here's to Robin Hood. It's interesting the way music gets around. The second tune was actually titled Lady Frances Neville's Delight. And this was again the Farnaby 1665 publication called The Dance Master, which was a marvelous collection of all English dances with single melody tunes to go along, so the fiddle player could accompany your dances. And someone came along much later, about in the early 1800s, and found this tune and said, this is not Lady Neville at all, this is Robin Hood, and wrote wonderful words to it. So here are two Robin Hood songs.
Thank you.
20th Century Fox movie starring Gene Tierney, Dana Andrews, Vincent Price, and Cliff Webb. In 1999, Laura was rated by the National Film Registry as one of the 10 best mystery films of all time. I believe that one of the factors that maintained the constant tension throughout the movie was the frequent use of a mysterious theme. Mystery is particularly true of the interesting chord under the name Laura, which is the first thing that you hear in the song. It is basically an A minor chord, which sounds like this, A, If you wish, you can join in the refrain, which is, let the toast pass, drink to the last.
Okay. Yeah, you guys will catch on. It's repeated many times.
Yeah, so it's on and on and on. So, three drinking songs, three English drinking songs.
Here's
oldest piece on this program. It is a song, not a dance. It's full of irregular rhythms. And that's something that's really neat about early music. It's not very square all the time. Sometimes you have, as in the last piece, it goes from two to three, and without any regard to the people who are having trouble reading music. So it's fascinating music, and it's one that people who get into early music get a little bit boring about. Nor are all the fanfares that I've thrown in.